Hi, hello, namaste. A very warm welcome to Bio Classes. We are in a continuation with gene expression regulation, a very interesting concept. So regarding that concept, we had started, that means yesterday we have started that lac operon model or lac operon concept. So what actually we are studying here? Genes are expressing, but the expression is controlled. That is, it is present in the controlled manner. That means something is going to control the gene expression. Some materials are going to control the gene expression. Some situations are controlling the gene expression. Some environmental conditions are controlling the gene expression. That means gene expression and its regulation we are studying here. In case of eukaryotic cell, gene expression, it is something concerned in one type. In case of prokaryotic cell, gene expression is concerned in another type. So particularly here we are studying gene expression regulation in the case of prokaryotes. So prokaryotes means in case of bacteria. In case of bacteria, how the gene expression get controlled. So to study that one, we had started that lac operon model. What that lac is? Lac means lactose. What that operon is? Operon means a group of genes having common promoter gene. The group of genes having common promoter. And here lac operon means here some genes group together helps in the metabolism of lactose. Some specific genes group together helps in metabolism of lactose. So here we have started that lac operon concept. By looking into that lac operon concept, how the mechanism is switching on and switching off. Say for example, in our body also we are having so many genes, thousands together genes we are having. But thing is, all the genes cannot express in all time and in all places. All genes cannot express in all time in all places. Some genes are expressing at some particular time and in some particular places. So for example, insulin gene, even though it is present in all the cells, but it is expressed in the cells of pancreas only. That means particular location. And in the same way, some genes are expressed in only sometimes, in some age, in some years. But some genes are expressed throughout the life. So here, digesting gene, let us consider. Digesting genes, in case of bacteria, so it is showing a switching on and switching off mechanism. That means gene expression. Sometimes switch on, sometimes switch off. So how actually that thing is happening? Let us consider. Lac operon model. Yes, so we had started a lac operon model. Who gave this model for the first time? Two scientists, Jacob and Monod. So in the 1961 they gave this model and they got the Nobel Prize also. So according to this lac operon, it is transcriptionally regulated lactose metabolism. So what I'll consider here, lac operon model or this concept, it is a transcriptionally regulated lactose metabolism. What this lactose is? Lactose is a carbon source. Lactose is the energy source. To whom? To bacteria. Which bacteria? E. coli bacteria. To the E. coli bacteria, lactose is a food. When that food enters inside the E. coli bacteria, that food has to be broken down. So that is a lactose metabolism. What it is? The lactose metabolism, breaking of lactose. And here to break the lactose, so there some particular enzymes are required. Those enzymes are produced from set of genes, group of genes, and all the genes are working together in the coordinated manner. So that we will call it as a lac-operon model, right? And this lac-operon model, for this model, this lactose, it is acting as inducer. Let me consider. Now the lactose, this material acting as an inducer, inducing, initiating, initiator. So for example, let me consider a pickle, mango pickle or a lemon pickle, whatever it is. When I keep the pickle in front of my mouth, then suddenly saliva starts secreting in my buccal cavity. Pickle is here, saliva starts secreting in the buccal cavity. That means now pickle is inducer. Inducer means the something which helps in initiating or which helps in inducing something. So here, when the lactose is present, then only genes are expressing. When the lactose absent, genes are not expressing. Because of that reason, lactose now it is considered to be the inducer. What it is called as? Inducer. It is a compulsory thing. When too much of sunlight is present, then automatically skin color becomes dark. Melanin production is more. That means melanin production gene is expressing because of that sunlight. That means the sunlight is inducer, just like pickle. And here the lactose is inducer. And whole thing, if genes are expressed, means we will consider it as a switch off, switch on mechanism. If genes are not expressed, we will call it as a switch off mechanism. Switch on mechanism, switch off mechanism. Two kinds we are having. So let us consider those two mechanisms one by one. The first one is switch off mechanism. The first one, switch off mechanism. That means here the genes are not expressing. Which genes? Genes are not expressing. Which genes? Structural genes. Yes, coming to previous class. Totally how many genes we were having? Six genes. Total six genes. I gene, P gene, O gene, Z gene, Y gene, A gene. I means regulator gene. P means promoter gene. O means operator gene. ZYA. These three genes are structural genes. And here, this Z gene, we also call it as lac-Z. Lac-Y. Lac-A. Lac means lactose. Lac-Z gene, Lac-Y gene, Lac-A gene. These three are structural genes. These structural genes are expressing. These structural genes are expressing, controlled by other three genes. What are those other three genes? I gene, P gene, O gene. Total six genes. So here, the mechanism may be switching off or switching on. Before going to that, let me tell you just on a brief introduction. Imagine this is one gene. It is on a gene or piece of the DNA. Now this piece of the DNA is a transcriptionally active. It shows a transcription. That means it is one transcription unit, right? So in this transcription unit, this portion, what it is? Promoter. And this portion, it is terminator. And in between, this is a structural gene. The total unit we will call it as a structure, a transcription unit, as already we know that one. Here box means a box will not be there. I am showing the specific sequences. So DNA is having the lines, base pair sequence. Here the base pair sequence are, we will refer them as promoter, here terminator. That means translation process starts from promoter and the transition moves in this direction and ends in the terminator. And the structural gene, nothing but, so the total mRNA quantity produced from this one, right? So promoter, here the transition process starts. Terminator, transition process ends. Starting point, ending point. Here in the promoter region, to start that process, one enzyme is required. One enzyme should be attached. What is that enzyme? Yes, here one enzyme is attached, and this enzyme is DNA dependent RNA polymerase. What is the enzyme name? DNA dependent. It is a DNA. On this DNA, one enzyme is depending. DNA dependent RNA polymerase. What is the work of RNA polymerase? RNA polymerase work is production of RNA from the DNA. RNA polymerase work is production of RNA from the DNA. That means transcription. So one more enzyme is there. DNA dependent DNA polymerase. So that enzyme work is production of DNA from DNA. Production of DNA from DNA that used in the replication process. Here I am talking about the transcription. In the transcription we can use. So we are going to see the RNA polymerase enzyme. And that enzyme attaches at which place? Promoter. After attaching on the promoter region, the enzyme moves up to terminator. It moves up to terminator. While it is moving on the terminator, it produces one mRNA. It produces one mRNA. That means transcription process is over.
Transcription is the process of formation of specific RNA sequence from the specific DNA sequence. This specific region of DNA that is transcribed is called transcription unit. In transcription unit, 5 prime to 3 prime is called the coding strand, and the other 3 prime to 5 prime is called the template strand. It is the template strand which is transcribed. The transcription unit is divided into 3 regions. The promoter region that switches on and off the gene, the coding region that encodes information, and the termination region that contains a specific sequence of nucleotides to locate the end of the gene. Transcription initiates when RNA polymerase recognizes and binds to the promoter site on the DNA. A transcription factor, sigma, helps in recognizing the initiator site. This sigma factor releases as soon as the RNA polymerase binds the promoter site. A portion of the DNA double helix at this site unwinds and the strands separate. The RNA polymerase moves along the DNA strand, synthesizing the single-stranded mRNA in 5' to 3' direction. Transcription terminates when RNA polymerase reaches a terminator site, signaling the end of the gene. Another factor called RHO factor helps it in this process. Once the RNA polymerase reaches the terminator site, the nascent RNA falls off, and so the RNA polymerase. The DNA helix then zips back together as the H bonds reform. mRNA then moves to the cytoplasm for protein synthesis.
Now, when this enzyme is moving on, which gene? Structural gene. Okay, coming to our lac operon. In the lac operon, which are those structural genes? Which are those structural genes? Lac, Z, Y, A. Three structural genes we are having. That means, this enzyme moves on the structural gene. Suppose if we control the movement of this enzyme, if we control the movement of this enzyme, then a gene expression can be controlled. This is the idea. If we control the movement of this enzyme, so this enzyme is moving on which gene? Structural gene. Which gene? Structural gene. But actually here one structural gene is there. This is one structural gene. But like that, in the lac operon, three structural genes are there. Z, Y, A. On the structural gene, the enzyme moves like this. Suppose if we stop or control the movement of this enzyme, then gene expression can be controlled. Then who is controlling that one? Majorly this inducer, lactose. Presence or absence of the lactose. Okay? Yes. So this is just one basic idea. Now, let me consider the lac operon. The segment of DNA I, P gene, O gene, Z gene, Y gene, A gene. Right now, leave this P promoter. This is also a promoter. Right now, leave it. Let us consider 6. I means regulator gene, promoter gene, operator gene. These three are structural genes. And all the three structural genes together form one mRNA. All the three structural genes will perform one mRNA, and that mRNA we will call it as lac mRNA or polycystronic mRNA. Now, how actually the process is occurring? Imagine now no lactose. So in the medium there is no lactose. Imagine bacteria is there. Which bacteria? E. coli bacteria. Imagine this is the E. coli bacteria, right? Rod shaped bacteria. Now surrounding the bacteria there should be food, and that the food should be entering inside the bacteria. Which food? Lactose. But now there is no lactose. That means there is no food. When there is no food inside, the genes, all of these genes, whether they will work or not, that is the thing. They will not work. Why? Because inside there is no food. Why? Because outside there is no food. When there is no food, food digesting enzymes are not produced. Why? Because the food digesting enzymes producing genes are not expressing. So that is the thing. How actually that thing is happening? See here, there is no lactose. Now here, for the whole process to control, this is the initiator. I means regulator gene. First, this regulator gene, first it produces one mRNA. Yes, what it is producing? First one mRNA. And this mRNA we will call it as a repressor mRNA. So we will call it as repressor mRNA. So you know the meaning, repress or suppress. That means something is going to stop some activities. So here this repressor mRNA work is, it is going to stop any one function or any one activity. Its meaning is repressing, suppressing. So now I gene, regulator gene, it coded one repressor mRNA. and production of mRNA means transcription. This process is transcription, right? Now this repressor mRNA next converting into, that means translated, it translated into one, okay, let me show here, it translated into one protein, it translated into protein, and that protein name is repressor protein. Yes, which protein? Repressor protein. Now this repressor protein, it is going to attach to the operator gene. This repressor protein will go and bind to which gene? Operator gene or operator sequence, you may call it as a gene or sequence. What is the work of operator? So there is a common term we have heard, operator. Operator means he will operate something. How he is going to operate? By switching on or switching off. That means, say for example, light operator. So light operator will be having one box of buttons and he will keep on switching on, switching off. So bulbs are going to switch on and switch off. That means he is the operator. In the same way, this operator gene is going to switch on or switch off the mechanism. Now see here. So regulator gene produces one repressor mRNA. That repressor mRNA translated into one protein. That protein goes and binds to the operator gene. Now it is bound to the operator gene. Now here, this is just like a key and this is just like a lock. Which one is key? Repressor is key. Which one is lock? Operator gene is the lock. So perfect key, it is locking with, it is going to match with perfect lock. That means one key, it is matching with one lock. Lock and key mechanism. In the same way, repressor protein is going to attach or it is going to bind to that operator gene. Now, backside to the operator gene, which gene is present here? Promoter gene. So just I explained here, promoter gene. On the promoter gene, one enzyme attached here already. What is that enzyme? Just I told you. That enzyme is, yes, DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Imagine, this is DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme. Now, what is the enzyme? What is the work of this enzyme? This enzyme should move on which genes? Move on which genes? Structural genes. Just I showed in the diagram, structural genes. Now which are the structural genes here? ZYA. Now this enzyme should move on the structural gene, but this movement is blocked by the repressor protein. Why? Because now the enzyme cannot move. Which enzyme? DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Where it is present? On the promoter gene. Promoter gene front side, here repressor protein is attached. Hence, the enzyme cannot move on the ZYA genes. That means those genes cannot work. If those genes cannot work, means then no mRNA production. That means there is no production of mRNA. Gene should produce mRNA. There is no production of mRNA. No production of mRNA means no protein. No protein means no enzyme. If there is no production of enzyme, means then the whole mechanism is switch off. The whole mechanism is switch off. Why the mechanism switch off? Why? Because there is no lactose, no food, hence no enzyme. If food present, means then automatically its digesting enzymes are released. So when there is no lactose means here inducer, when there is no inducer, the whole mechanism is shut down, switch off. Yes, the who is going to switch off the mechanism here? Operator gene. That means operator gene, it is going to control the whole process, and that operator gene, it is blocked by regulator gene, the first starting one. By which protein? Repressor protein. Now the whole process is stopped. Whole process is stopped by this protein, repressor protein. right? Now let us continue, consider the another situation when a lactose is present. So let us consider the second one. Switch on a mechanism. Yes, let me draw the same diagram again, same operon. Yes, the major genes, let me mark them PIPOZYA. Same diagram I have shown there. Now this is, let us consider a different situation. When a lactose absent, mechanism is switch off. When lactose present, now let us consider when a lactose present. Now it is having the lactose. That means food is present. When food enters inside the body, food digesting enzymes are released. In the same way, when a lactose enters the E. coli cell, then a lactose digesting enzymes are released. That means mechanism is switch on. Then how the mechanism is going to switch on? Same as it is. So starting this regulator gene, first it is going to produce what? So starting it is going to produce one mRNA. Which mRNA? Yes, as it is, repressor mRNA. Repressor mRNA. And next, this repressor mRNA, it is translated into a protein. So it is translated into what? It is translated into a protein. Which protein? Repressor protein. Yes, the whole process is same as it is. Now, what is the work of repressor protein? It will go and bind to which gene? Operator gene. Why? Because it is just like a key and that is just like a lock. Both are matching. It is going to bind there. Now it is going to bind here, but one change is there. Now lactose is present inside the bacterial body. There is lactose. Now imagine this is a lactose. Okay, yes. Okay. This is a lactose. Lactose, another name is inducer. Now lactose is present. This lactose binds with the repressor protein. This lactose binds with the repressor protein. So then the structure becomes like this. This is a inducer and this one is, yes, and this is repressor. Repressor and inducer, one complex is created. So that is, I will call it as RI complex. Yes, which complex? RI complex. R means repressor, I means inducer. Inducer means lactose. Now food is present. That present food combines with repressor protein, so becomes RI complex. Now when only repressor present, this shape matches with operator gene. It will go and bind there. But now shape of the repressor protein changed. Why? Because repressor protein attached with the lactose. Now this cannot bind to operator gene. It cannot bind. Now it cannot bind to which gene? Operator gene. When it cannot bind to the operator gene, already backside to the operator gene, already one enzyme is attached. Which enzyme? Yes. DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme is already attached to promoter gene. Now this enzyme can easily move on ZYA. Why? Because there is no disturbance. But here it cannot move, this enzyme. Why? Because there is a disturbance. So here the road is blocked, but here there is no blockage of road. Now the enzyme moves on ZYA. When the enzyme moves on these genes, accessing the genes, then these three genes together, they are going to produce one mRNA. All the three genes, they are going to produce one mRNA. Right? And this mRNA, we will call it as lac mRNA. What we will call it as? Lac mRNA. Lac means lactose. And it is one type of polycystronic mRNA. So it is one kind of polycystronic mRNA. What is the meaning of polycystronic mRNA? More than one genes. More than one genes producing one mRNA. More than one genes producing one mRNA. That is polycystronic mRNA. Now, but in case of a eukaryotic gene, one gene produces one mRNA. But here three genes produces one mRNA. Polycystronic mRNA. Now, this polycystronic mRNA undergoes translation. So, it next undergoes translation. After the translation, it produces three enzymes. After the translation of this lac mRNA, it produces three enzymes. It codes for three enzymes. The first one is beta galactosidase. The first enzyme, beta galactosidase. Second enzyme, permease. And a third one is transacetylase. Three enzymes got produced here. So here Z gene codes for beta galactosidase, Y gene codes for permease, A gene codes for transacetylase. That means one gene producing one enzyme, but thing is all the three enzymes together first forms one mRNA. That is polycystronic mRNA. Now here, if you come to know their work, beta galactosidase, its work is breaking of lactose. Beta galactosidase gene enzyme work is breaking of lactose. Breaking of lactose into glucose and galactose. Into glucose and galactose. Then what is the work of permease? The name itself suggests permease, permission, permitting. That means suppose if this is the cell, means now outside the cell, which cell? Bacterial cell. Outside the cell lactose is present. Now that the lactose should enter inside the cell. So for the entry of lactose inside the cell, someone has to give the permission. So that permission is given by permease enzyme. That means it will make the entry of lactose into the cell. It will allow the lactose into the cell, or it will allow the food into the cell. So this is the entry, for entry of food. So that work is done by permease. Then transacetylase enzyme. Actually, this enzyme work is not well understood. We don't know the clear function done by that enzyme. But thing is, this enzyme, it will help to beta galactosidase. That will help to beta galactosidase. So or in how it is going to help means the name itself suggests transferring. Acetylase means acetyl group. It is on functional group. So acetyl functional group can be transferred to the beta galactosidase enzyme by this enzyme. That means this enzyme helps in transferring of acetyl group. It helps in transferring of acetyl group to this enzyme. When acetyl group is transferred to this enzyme, that enzyme will be promoted. Its work will be passed faster. So that acetyl group is transferred by this enzyme. So totally we got three enzymes: beta galactosidase, permease, transacetylase. So the whole mechanism we will consider as a switch on mechanism, and this is switch off mechanism, right? So switch on and switch off, both the mechanisms are majorly occurring because on the basis of whether lactose is present or absent. Lactose absent, mechanism switch off. Lactose present, mechanism switch on. Here switch on means production of enzymes. Switch off means no production of enzymes. No mRNA, no protein, no enzymes. Here mRNA produces, proteins produces, those proteins are converted into enzymes. This is switch on mechanism and this is switch off mechanism.
The E. coli lac operon is an example of an inducible set of genes. These genes are responsible for the breakdown of lactose into sugars used for cellular metabolism. This inducible system also involves bacterial DNA, a repressor, mRNA, and the sugar molecule lactose. This animation will only focus on two of the three proteins encoded by the lac operon: beta-galactosidase and permease. Gene expression can be induced or turned on when a specific inducer molecule appears in a cell. For inducible systems, a repressor molecule prevents gene expression by binding to the upstream controlling region. Lactose is the lac operon inducer molecule. After first appearing in the cellular environment, lactose passively enters the E. coli cell and binds to the repressor molecule. This binding releases the repressor from the controlling region. At this point, RNA polymerase can begin transcription of the operon. Here we show two of the three lac operon genes being transcribed into mRNA. Ribosomes then bind to the mRNA and the two proteins are translated. The first protein is beta-galactosidase, which breaks down lactose into two simple sugars. The second protein is permease, a membrane-bound protein. When embedded in the cell membrane, permease functions to provide a direct route for the lactose outside the cell to be imported into the cell. This import occurs at a much greater rate than the passive transfer we first observed. Because translation continues inside the cell, other permease proteins become embedded in the membrane. This further increases the rate at which lactose enters the cell. Beta-galactosidase breaks the cellular lactose into the simple sugars glucose and galactose. Once its concentration is greatly reduced, the lactose bound to the repressor are released. At this point, the repressor again binds to the controlling region and gene expression is halted. For all inducible systems like the lac operon, it is the interaction of the repressor and inducer molecules that mediate gene expression.
And one more thing, keep one thing. This whole lac operon model, or this gene regulation, it is negative gene regulation. Yes. So the lac operon gene regulation. In this model, the gene regulation is a negative regulation. So actually we are having two types of gene regulations, positive and negative. This is a negative. Why? Because always most of the times the genes are inactive. Whenever there is lactose, then only genes are expressing. Whenever there is lactose, then only genes are expressing. If no lactose, then genes cannot express. Then who is controlling that one? Repressor. Who is controlling that one? Repressor. Why? Because repressor get produced continuously. That continuously produced repressor will attach here. Continuous. That process occurs continuously. That means because of that reason we will consider it as a negative regulation. And here, okay, see just one imagine, just a differentiation you see here. ZYA3 genes. These three genes cannot express continuously. Whenever lactose, then only these genes are expressing. But what about this gene? I gene. I gene is working continuously. Even lactose is absent, then also I gene is working. Even lactose present, then also I gene is working. That means those genes are continuously working genes. That means there are two kinds of genes. One is housekeeping gene. So let me write here. The first one is housekeeping gene, and the second one is luxury gene. Yes, the first one is housekeeping gene and second one is a luxury gene. Housekeeping gene means these genes are continuously expressing in all the situation, just like a regulator gene, continuously expressing even lactose present or absent. But luxury genes means those genes cannot work continuously, those genes cannot express continuously. Only in certain time they will express, only in certain condition they will express, depending on some materials. Just like these genes will express whenever there is lactose. If no lactose means these genes cannot express. That means two types of genes, luxury genes and housekeeping gene. So here this is housekeeping gene and these are luxury genes, right? And here all the three genes together we will call them as controlling genes. These three genes together we will call them as structural genes. Three structural genes, three control genes together form lac operon. Here all the genes are working with coordination with regulator manner. And the total concept, who gave this total concept? Yes, Jacob and Monod. Because of that reason this model also called as a Jacob Monod model. So in 1965 for this kind of explanation they got a Nobel Prize. It is a very interesting one. And once in the NCERT book, so once see this concept, right? Once see the concept, and I will give the notes also. Write down the notes, take the notes. And if you are having any doubts regarding this concept, please text me in the comment box. Please give your any of the feedbacks, right? So in the next class, so we are having very interesting one, HGP, Human Genome Project. So in this entire chapter the very interesting concept is HGP, very very interesting one. From the next class onwards let us start Human Genome Project. Yes, thank you.